Yo, what's the deal? How everybody doing today? I just want to share this. Find a reason to love. Find something that motivates you to want to do something positive, productive for somebody else. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we got to stop being so confrontational amongst ourselves. Like, why we fight amongst ourselves, but we treat outsiders like they're royalty? Like, that makes no sense. And I'm talking from an international standpoint, also to a local standpoint. Us as a people, we have to stop bickering. We have to stop fighting amongst one another. Like, you feel me? Like, all right, this person is a Christian. This person is a Muslim. Like, how can we meet in the middle and exchange our own philosophies and build something around that to where we can bring it out here to our kids? You feel what I'm saying? And a lot of people's like, stop clout chasing. Stop, like, trying to be at odds with other people that you feel is of the same caliber of you, on the same mission and page as you. And, like, let's love on each other. Like we all can be gangsters. We all can do some gangster shit, do some stupid shit. How you doing, big brother? Peace and blessings to you. We all can do that. But it's like, we didn't prove to the world that we can be ignorant. We didn't prove to the world that we can be dumb. We didn't prove to the world that we can be ruthless towards one another. Like, when are we going to be more benevolent towards one another? When is we going to start showing each other more love? Like, I don't want to beef for no Africans. I don't want beef with nobody. You feel what I'm saying? If I say something that opposes you, or if I say something that you feel like is indirectly at you, talk to me about it. Confront me. Let's talk. Let's share philosophies. Let's build a foundation off of that to where we can start sharing these philosophies and these teachings with these kids. Let's build the minds of these youth. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to be at odds with nobody, like, but yet people want to be at odds with me. Like, why? Why be at odds with me? Why be at odds with a person that want to be at odds with nobody? I don't know. I'm me. I'm Ye Ye. I've been Ye Ye all these years. I'm going to continue to be Ye Ye till I no longer exist in this physical realm of existence. You feel what I'm saying? I'm not no leader. I'm just like everybody else. I sin. I cuss. Yes, mama. Yes. Okay. Can you guys cut the key off? Can you turn the key to the left, please? Thank you. If y'all want to listen to the music, listen to the music. But just please don't start up the car, okay?
Kevin, what happened to your other phone?
Someone stole it. I'm sorry. Because I should have been gave y'all that phone, but I was procrastinating with cleaning out some of my personal stuff and factory resetting so that I could give it to y'all. Now it's stolen. So I apologize. But it's okay. Don't get sad. Don't be distraught because we're going to figure it out. Shake hands. Shake hands. Isn't your birthday coming up? Can you, big homie, how you doing? Peace and blessings, family. Yes, sir. Peace and blessings. I'm blessed, big homie. I don't want to get you on this camera. Yes, sir. I will. I will, big homie. I appreciate that, man. Yes, sir. I will, big homie. Thank you. Love you, big homie. Hey, yeah. But can you at least just work with me? Can you bear with me? I told you I was going to get you what I got you. I got that for you. I told you I was going to get you what I got you, and I got that for you. Peace and blessings, family. How you doing? You all right?
Yeah.
Stay blessed, bro. Yeah, but, thank you. Go ahead. Listen to it. Open up the sunroof. Hey, yeah, but as I was saying, like, you got some peoples who feel like you may have more than them, and it may not be that because when you get to the nitty-gritty of everything, it's not about... Yes. It's not about materialism. It's about knowledge, wisdom, and understanding and creating new paths so that we can lead these kids into a new way of living and a new way of thinking. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we didn't try the gangbanging shit. This shit ain't working for us. We didn't try to be big cocaine drug bosses and cocaine dealers and crystal meth dealers and users and all this type of shit. This shit ain't working for us. Like, let's try another narrative. Yes, yes, mama. Okay, that's perfect. Just don't start up the car. It's totally cool. Okay. It's totally cool. It's okay. She can be right there. Yeah, but as I was saying, like, we didn't try all this negative shit that these people then gave us. Like, we didn't have very many outlets. So when you don't have very many outlets, of course, you're going to utilize what you have at your fingertips, which was crime, self-hate, destruction, and all these conditions of the mind that they gave to us. Like, all right, we understand that. But now we in a a time of knowledge. 2020 represents balance, revelation, manifestation. Like, when is we going to start utilizing what's available to us now under this new mindset, under this new mind frame, and start building something different and creating different narratives? Like, even what's going on right now, all we need to do is unify Crips, Bloods, Gangsters, Disciples. Like, let's stop fighting each other. Let's appoint representation from each hood, each community, and let's open up these lines of communication. So when shit start going willy-nilly, then we can get on these phones and we can, you know, hey, man, what's going on? What's up with this? And it was once about a time that I had established that with the Jordan Down Housing Projects, the Gray Streets, like, you feel me? But being that people have vested interest in this killing and targeting, victimizing each other, a lot of people wasn't in favor of it. But it's okay. It's cool, because when the right time come, like, I'ma still continue to push for peace. Like, I'ma still continue to push for the peoples who are at the bottom. Like, I'ma continue to do that because I've been at the bottom all my life. So how could I not fight, and how could I not, you know, voice my opinion and give my testimony of how it was, how it is at the bottom? Because I'm still at the bottom, like, you feel me? But peoples don't understand, man. But what I will say, man, y'all stay up, take care of each other, and be blessed, man. I'm about to end this thing, man. Y'all stay up, man. And you know, keep the prayers up, man, because all this shit that we're going through right now, it's all about design. These peoples is orchestrating this. We playing into their hand. Yes, we are playing into their hand. But at the end of the day, are we supposed to continue to let these peoples just kill us? Are we supposed to continue to let these peoples just victimize us and beat us, and we don't fight back at all? Like, when do we fight back? Do we ever fight back? Can we win a fight? Like, these are conversations we need to start having. Like, and peoples talk about independency, like, we didn't have independent, self-sufficient and thriving communities. And what did they do? They got rid of it. Atlanta, Georgia was the mecca for African Americans here. What did they do? They went out there and they dropped off A's here. Infect you motherfuckers with this. Allensville or Allensworth in Central California was a thriving agricultural black community. What did they do? They went up there and poisoned the water supplies and drove all them peoples out to Oakland, Fresno, and all that. You feel what I'm saying? Seneca Village in New York, a thriving black community. What they went, they knocked all that shit down and built Central Park. Black Wall Street, what did they do? They went over and they killed all of them and took their shit. What's up, bro?
What's up, bro?
How you doing? Don't call me, bro. I'm your father. You all right?
Yeah.
You want to be on my camera?
Who that?
This is my son. What you mean for what? Because I want to build memories with you. You my son. I love you, man. Y'all my everything. What you about to get into?
Nothing.
Okay.
I'm looking for RJ's sister. She stole $100 from the nation.
Wait, don't say that on camera. God bless y'all. I